Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. A very good morning to our lecturer, Madam Muna, and all my fellow friends. We are from group number 5, presented by me, Amir Zabir Khanudin, Muhammad Fairuz, Nuruddin Helmi, Muhammad Arif, and Ahmad Shah. Today, we will explain about creative and innovation. Basically, nowadays, organization is determined how fast innovation and creativity can be incorporated to organization and business world. Creativity means constantly expanding process of innovation and progress. In other words, it will be an important key to any effort how to success in innovation and business world. Creativity in company should be able to provide innovation and contribute to solve problem. New ideas are often accepted as a main creativity manager. We are choosing Google as a role model that apply creativity and innovation. A little bit information about Google. Google is an American multinational technology that specializes in internet related service and goods. Founded in 1998 by Larry Page and Sergey Brin, basically they are the scientist computer, and now they are the president and CEO of Alphabet Incorporation, which is the parent company of Google itself. Google has 57,100 employees, which is 30% of the employees is female, and another 70% are male. An average salary for Google employees is between $60,000 to $166,000 per year. Since 2010, Google has been purchasing an average one company for a week. Example for company belong to Google is Waze, YouTube, and Android. Next, we will present by the Nuruddin.
I'll be presenting about the first issue and the first findings. Okay, the first issue that we had is the unwillingness of company to accept the ideas from lower level of employees. As you all know, we have two types of management, which is the autocratic and democratic. Autocratic is the way which the management which decisions are unilateral, and democratic means that every level of employees get the opportunity to say. Mostly, management choose to go with autocratic way. This discourages the great ideas from the lower level of employees, and some great ideas cannot be spoken. From our findings, Google has been known to treat their employees in a democratic way. Their informal system, 20% policy, has been a great way to generate ideas from every level of employees. 20% policy is a policy which let the employees of Google or the engineers of Google to go with their passion project of their own and be entrepreneurial about it. They can spend 1/5 of their time of working hour in a weekly basis or monthly basis to go with an entrepreneurial project of their own. Okay. This policy has led to generation of ideas from every level of employees. It's related in our syllabus, participative management has emerged as an important concept of motivation and productivity because this approach to managing can heighten employees' confidence. For example, employee involvement can motivate workers by providing more opportunities of growth, responsibility and commitment in the work itself.
The second problem that we have discussed is the unwillingness of most of the company to provide fund and incentive due to risk that they have to face. They think that the idea from the employee is too risky and uncertain. They don't want to spend money too much but achieving absolutely nothing. They will be hard to compete with the other companies since they have no innovation and creativity idea to create a new product. There are four innovation risks that they have to face, which is failing to meet the quality, the cost of the innovative and creativity project. They think they fail to attract customers and investing in a successful innovation project. Most of manager manage the risk that I have tell just now. The Google give an incentive in monetary and honorary recognition. Even though putting entrepreneurial innovation model into practice requires significant commitment, investment, and participation from all area of the company, they manage to take the risk. So as a conclusion here, sometimes the organization and company need some change to improve the performance.
Okay, for my part, I would like to talk about the organizational structure. So normally, an organizations they rely on traditional ideas and past practices to resolve their problem. So if you look at Google, one of the innovation that they applied on the organizational structure, they use a very flat management hierarchy. So from this, a very flat management hierarchy means that every Google employee, staff, or groups can report directly to their CEO and bypass the middle management. So other than that, they can also share information with their teams since they use the matrix structure for their organizational structure. So one of the obvious effects from using a very flat management hierarchy is that they would cause a little chaos in their office and things such as project duplications. So Google doesn't see this problem as a normal problem. They use this problem and they see this as an opportunity to use it for innovations. And even though there are a lot of things happen such as project duplications increase the number of projects would make the acceleration of their time to market. So by letting more flowers bloom, they will have the more feedback on what customers consider valuable. From this we know the goals of Google is to determine the necessary amount of management that they needed. So if they walk into the office and they feel comfortable and does not feel any nervous about things that are going on in the office, that means they have taken the management that they needed too far.
So at the conclusion of our presentation, we can see that every company needs to apply their creativity and innovative in their daily business. As we can see, Google has taken a variety of approaches for them to come up with new ideas every time they perform their job and tasks. Second one is willing to take risks and be capable enough to manage a failure. We can see that Google is willing to take a risk even though there's a chance for them to fail every time they test their new idea that they created. Okay, the last one is does not rely on traditional ideas. For example, Google does not rely on their traditional ideas, but instead they apply their creativity and innovative to their creation and their problems.